you just viewed what happened 2 weeks ago here on Mid-South Wrestling. You saw his hand raised. That signifies officially and sanctioned that he is the new North American Heavyweight Champion, the Junkyard Dog. This week we have a lot of exciting action coming up. Battle of the Powerhouse Grapplers from Minnesota, Crusher Darso, as he takes on Russian Nikolai Volkov. Popular Mr. Wrestling 2 returns on this week's card, and you'll see a rugged team, the Road Warriors. It all adds up to a lot of excitement. The man to tell you about it, our guest commentator, Cowboy Bill Watts.
Well, like you said, you just saw Junkyard Dog regaining the North American title, a title he lost July 16th, 1983, in a 2-out-of-3 fall, no disqualification match in the Superdome when Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer and King Kong Bundy helped take the toll, and Butch Reed won the title. And that's heating up, and it looks like something's got to give, because last week here, Hacksaw Butch Reed, with an unprovoked tack on an already injured man, King Cobra, had been defeated by Nikolai Volkov. We'd gone to a commercial break, and this is what had happened. What is Butch Reed doing now? What's Butch Reed doing? Got a can of paint and a brush. Well, no man is his brother. Oh, he just threw the referee out. Well, it looks like we got some action we didn't bargain for, boy. Butch Reed is punishing King Cobra for no reason. No reason. He's got him up into a slam. Cobra was just devastated. Oh, he was just devastated by Volkov, and now Reed's on him. I don't know why. There's no reason.
I'm like you, Bill. Butch Reed is in the ring, but I don't know what for.
I think the man flipped his lid, boys. I think the man has flipped his ever-loving lid. This thing with him and the dog has driven him mad.
There's a third referee in there trying to halt him, and out he goes.
I guarantee you, those refs don't want back in there, and I don't blame him. He's crazy. He got the yellow paint. The yellow paint.
What in the world?
That's a direct challenge of the Junkyard Dog. The yellow paint. Reed has challenged the Junkyard Dog.
Right down the middle of his back.
Right down the middle of his back. Here comes the dog with his chain. Reed better get out of there. For that unprovoked attack, Hacksaw Reed was fined by Mid-South $500. That doesn't in any way help to solve the degradation to King Cobra. And Hacksaw Reed has made his point, but I think Mid-South wants him to take a look at the new North American champion to the music of the Atomic Dog. Let's look at this.
J.Y.D., as his friends call him, has some special reasons for taking time out to visit children and those stricken by misfortune. This is a mighty big day in Travis Mathurin's life. The young man honestly feels his luck has changed, and that is good news. I'm Ed Martin for Channel 4, Eyewitness News.
dog, the old music, another one bites the dust there. The Junkyard Dog, the North American Heavyweight Champion. We have a lot more exciting things to come. You'll view them along with us right after this word from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
Hacksaw Reed was upset about the $500 fine for what he did to King Cobra when he was unable to defend himself. And Jim Ross interviewed him earlier. Let's listen to that.
Last week, right here on Mid-South Wrestling, for no apparent reason, Hacksaw Butch Reed, with an unprovoked attack during a commercial break on King Cobra, not only did you humiliate and degrade the man, you painted a yellow streak down his back. For your actions, Mid-South Wrestling has fined you $500. And I know at this point in time, you have some words to say regarding that incident.
I ain't here out here to talk about King Cobra. King Cobra got just what he deserved, you understand? Because he ain't up but a junkyard dog stooge. What I'm out here talking about is slander against my person, you understand? The junkyard dog run around here signifying about I got a little old puppy dog leading him around on the chain and painted a yellow streak up and down his back. Well, let me make one thing clear. Butch Reed is not cruel to animals, you understand? I do not go around abusing dumb animals, you understand? There's only one dog that I want to paint and lead around on a chain, and that's that greasy junkyard dog. All right. You understand that?
I understand, but what's in this box? What's in this box?
Show him what's in the box, brother. I'm going to show you just to prove to all you people what's in that box. Let him out of there. That dog is not abused in any kind of way at all. Do you see him? Look at him. He's half scared now. He's just like a junkyard dog.
This dog
a
feels wet.
Caring dog.
This dog feels.
He's a little scared dog. I'm his master. You understand? I'm that dog's master. And that's the way I'm going to have the junkyard dog. He's going to be my master, licking my hands and licking my boots. And dog, then I'm going to put this chain on you and lead you around with a yellow streak up and down your back, sucker.
The comment that interested me the most was Jim Ross said, that dog looks like it's wet. You wonder if Hacksaw Reed and Neidhart hadn't scrubbed it off right before it got here and maybe gotten rid of the evidence. Anyway, let's go to the ring and Reeser Bob for the next bout.
This is a non-title tag team event for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions at 260 pounds from Kansas City, Missouri, Hacksaw Butch Reed. And his partner at 295 pounds from Reno, Nevada, Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Across the ring at 238 pounds from Indianapolis, Indiana, George Weingroff. And his partner at 227 pounds from Tennessee, Randy Barber.
Thank you, Al. The introduction of the tag team match, the Raging Bull, Randy Barber, as he takes off his jacket, and his partner from Indianapolis, Indiana, former amateur great from the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga, George Weingroff, who's ready for action. And action against their opponents will be the Mid-South Tag Team title holders, Hacksaw Butch Reed on the outside of the ring, and representing the team inside, the Anvil, Jim Neidhart. Bill?
Well, I'll guarantee you, I don't care what you think of Neidhart and Reed, they are powerful, powerful athletes. Between the two of them, Boyd Pierce, they can bench press 1,100 pounds. Now that's awesome. The fact that they grew up with a mean streak and they're a little bit of a bully, that's a personality problem, but they are tough. They're against a tough man, a top heavyweight from University of Tennessee at Chattanooga, George Weingroff. Hacksaw Butch Reed, $500 fine for his attack on King Cobra. Good fireman's carry. Beautiful thing. You know, when you got great technique, kid, I don't care how big and strong he is, you can execute it. Whether you stay on top of the situation and put him to the mat and pin him, that's another thing. Right there, he went for his technique, but he went into the power of Neidhart, and Neidhart scooped him right up with that tremendous power, and I bet he cracked every vertebrae at his back. Dr. Cyrus Anderson, my old buddy, the chiropractor in Tulsa, Oklahoma, he gets paid for giving you those type of adjustments. Or he gets paid for straightening out those kind of adjustments, I might say. Reed, George Weingraf's a great athlete. Great athlete. These are the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. And, of course, last week, they arrested Dusty Rhodes and Hacksaw Dugan when Nikolai Volkov, the Russian dreadnought, so upset over having a North American title that he had taunted Magnum TA into putting up an unsanctioned match and had it stripped from him as Mid-South made that landmark decision 2 weeks ago. He attacked Dusty Rhodes last week with a 100-pound bag of wheat, which is, you know, you just pick up 100 pounds of mass and imagine him picking it up and carrying it. But he ran across the floor here and drove it into Dusty Rhodes, split it everywhere, and left the American Dream. And, of course, the Dream just started crying again a little bit later. These are the Mid-South Tag Team Champions. Reed and Neidhart, they won them from Magnum TA and Hacksaw Dugan, right here on television. Oh, bear hug on Barber. Look, Reed just walking out. He's a powerlifter in college, an All-American football player on the college powerlifting team, played for the Kansas City Chiefs. Neidhart played for the Oakland Raiders, Dallas Cowboys, UCLA is a college. World champion in throwing the blacksmith anvil. And like he said, what can you do to a blacksmith anvil? You can hit it, it doesn't dent it. You can throw it down, it doesn't hurt it. It's just you can't destroy it. And that's exactly what he says, that he has the same ability. You can't destroy it. And he's picking on Hacksaw Dugan, saying clean up, that you need a flea collar, you need a haircut and a shave, you need to be dusted, and all the lice and the vermin on you exterminated. And you see Jim Neidhart, and you wonder what grounds he has for accusing anybody of that type of situation. He doesn't exactly look like he's just stepped out of a fashion magazine himself. There he goes with that fireman's carry type fall away. A devastating hole. That powerful man just drove Randy Barber in.
As the winners of the tag team match, the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, Jim the Anvil Neidhart and Hacksaw Butch Reed. We'll be back after this important word.
Nikolai Volkov, a powerful man, a man proud of his country, says he sends half his earnings home to buy Russian war bonds so that they can strengthen Russia to keep the peace around the world. If you can imagine somebody like him looking straight in the eye and telling you that. But he attacked the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, last week during tag match. Let's watch that. Reed, oh, Reed just collected one. Reed put right on the floor, Dusty Rhodes, American Dream, there's Neidhart. Crossbody block by Rhodes. He's got him. One, two. No. Reed pulls Rhodes out by the hair. You got a fight going. You got a fight going there. Dugan's keeping Neidhart from jumping in from behind. Dusty Rhodes. Oh. Volkov just hit Dusty Rhodes in the head with a 100-pound bag of wheat.
Rick Carrera calls for the bell.
He just ran Dusty's head into that steel post. Volkov hit him with that 100-pound bag of wheat, split it all over. But the bell is called. They got him in a Boston Crab. They got Dugan in a Boston Crab. The referee's calling for the DQ, but Rhodes is what got him. He cannot help him. He cannot help him. Here comes Magnum TA. Magnum TA coming to help him. There comes the Junkyard Dog in. Dusty Rhodes has not moved. He's laying out here on that cold concrete floor. And there's some wild action going inside here. Shows he can kick too.
Dusty Rhodes is not loose. There's wheat scattered all over. The referee coming to see about Dusty Rhodes.
You saw the attack. We saw later what Dusty Rhodes sees, did in return. And you know one thing, the American Dream said, step aside, he's mine. We'll see, because right now we're going to go to the ring to Reese or Bowden. We have a match with a man that's only been defeated once on Mid-South, and that by Junkyard Dog, Crusher Darso, against the Russian Juggernaut.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 313 pounds, from Moscow, Russia, Nikolai Volkov. And across the ring at 303 pounds from northern Minnesota, Crusher Darso.
Hey, 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 hey,
I brought Russian Ashinada here so they can play that I want those girls to get up and say I'm salute me. Because I bring this and they can't find it. They was lying to me. Now I find I want to hear. And I demand it.
Well, you heard that. Nikolai Volkov has demanded that we play the Russian national anthem.
National anthem, and the Russian Nikolai Volkov, as Bill told you, against Crusher Darso, who's only suffered one defeat here on Mid-South Television. That was the Junkyard Dog.
Darso's carrying it to him, Boyd. Crusher Darso, only one man beat him on Mid-South, the Junkyard Dog. Nikolai Volkov was standing in perfect attention for the national anthem of Russia. That's not unusual in any Olympic type contest or international contest. Generally, the athlete's anthem is played either before or after the contest, and everybody respects it. I just think the professional wrestling crowd are not going to stand still and listen to Nikolai Volkov's Russian national anthem with any respect after all the horrible things he's said about the United States. He's an awesome machine, a man who thought he had the North American title and was stripped of that title in a landmark decision. You hear the crowd chanting, USA, USA, USA. And we heard Dusty Rhodes, after that vicious attack when Volkov was up there hollering about being stripped of the title, and Dusty Rhodes came back in with hands taped, and what an impassioned plea he made. And he said, step aside, Dog, and Dugan, this one's mine. Bear hug. Darso's got the big Russian in a bear hug. He's got the Russian in a bear hug. Listen to the crowd. Powerful man. Barry Darso, Crusher Darso, a powerful young man. He's got him in that bear hug. These are two giants. Look at that strength. Look at Darso. Every tendon, every muscle, every nerve. The Russian trying to get the power to hit him, but Darso's putting the pain on him. He's got that back crushed. Crusher Darso would love to beat this man just to shut up his big mouth about sending his money back to Russia to buy Russian war bonds so Russia can keep the peace in the world. But the United States, for no reason, attacked Grenada. The United States is causing trouble in the oil countries. Can you, I don't know how they get so brainwashed.
And yet they do, Bill. And
the Russian is maneuvering there on the far side. You can see one arm through. He's got one arm underhooked. He's got an underhook on Crusher Darso. He may break that powerful bear hug. Now he's got a double underhook. He's got underneath the strength of Darso's bear hug. Look at that Russian. Look at him. Just power in. He powered in against 300-pound Crusher Darso and broke that bear hug. He broke it. Look at this awesome strength. Now he's leaning Darso down. He's got him helplessly up in the air, completely off his feet. He has completely handled Crusher Darso. It's just astounding to me the ease that this powerful machine. And as I say, the only man who had beat Darso, the only person, was the Junkyard Dog. Darso, a powerful individual. other Russian grinding him with the boots. Powerfully attacking, never backing away. The Russian, the winner of a couple of the biggest battle royals in Mid-South history. Come in here and I'll tell you, he's really livid about the fact that he... Oh! All right, Garso! Russians, you cannot repeat the same maneuver. You can never repeat the same maneuver. They're too well schooled in their technique and their psychology and their training that if you hit them with the same maneuver twice, they're going to catch you up every time. Look at that. Now he's taunting Darso. He's taunting him, hollering at him to get up. He's taunting his manhood, challenging him. Hacksaw Jim Dugan is just chomping at the bit to get at this man. Oh! Boy, I ache when I see the power of this man. 600-pound one-hand deadlift at age 17. The crowd's trying to rally the support with the USA, but Crusher Darso's in the hands of a Russian bear, a man that's diabolical in his power and his strength and his dedication. Look at him, just lift, look at that. One, two, three, inside cradle, it's over.
And it gains a victory, and Nikolai Volkov, the Russian, remains undefeated here
Dusty
on Mid-South Wrestling.
The Junkyard Dog may have the contest of their life.
Exactly, boys. And we'll be back with the tag team action after this word.
It's tag team action now for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at a total combined weight of 587 pounds, the number one rated tag team, the national tag team champions, the Road Warriors. And across the ring at 245 pounds from St. Joseph, Missouri, Mike Bond. And his partner at 250 pounds from Topeka, Kansas, Art Cruz.
Tag team action now being introduced in the black trunks, Art Cruz and Mike Bond, the taller of the two, against, as Reeser told you, the national tag team champions, the Road Warriors. Bill?
Without a doubt, they're the number one contenders for the Mid-South tag team titles. As Reeser Bowden told you, they're the national tag team champions. But that makes them just number one in line for the Mid-South Tag Champions. And I'd like to see the Road Warriors against Butch Reed and Jim the Anvil Neidhart. There's some guys that would try to tear each other apart, literally. Hawk out there, he tags an animal. These guys are devastatingly powerful. They're unscrupulous. Jerry Clower, my good buddy, great country music comedian, fine Christian man, was telling me he ran into him in the airport in Atlanta, and he said they're the first wrestlers he's ever met, even in the airport, that are surly and non-communicated, because Jerry loves pro wrestling. He's a big fan. When he first became so famous, he still, and still does, he and his daughter go to the match in Jackson, Mississippi often, and all the guys really say howdy to him, and he really enjoys it. But he said these guys were just, they just wouldn't even say hi, you know, they ignored him and just said, you know, some things we can't repeat here on TV. And Jerry was really, as a professional man, he thought that was really low class. They fast tag. I guess you don't get paid for class in the business they're in, though. They're out there to wreck people, and they certainly do that well. They're awesome. They're just like battering rams. They don't have a lot of regard for their own personal safety, and much in the same type mentality as far as their own personal well-being as Jim Hacksaw Dugan. And of course, this thing with Junkyard Dog and Butch Reed, as you can see, is going beyond any bound of sanity. I mean, where they're down to, Butch Reed says, I'm going to paint a yellow streak up your back. Dog says you might beat me on a given day. That's going to be if you take the living heart right out of me. But he said, if you ever think you're going to paint me, I'd have to be dead. No man's going to paint me. Oh, Mike Bond walked into a vicious clothesline by Animal. 1, 2, 3.
E.B. Anderson calls for the bell.
Cruz came in and went right out as Hawk just threw him out like yesterday's newspaper.
The Road Warriors are the winners, and we'll have more interesting things after this word from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
Boy, today is the day of specialization, and I think there's been an exciting new concept in professional wrestling. And Reeser Bowden was talking to Magnum TA and Mr. Wrestling 2, and let's join that interview.
As you know, we live in a world of specialization. In the field of medicine, I think we'll all agree that specialization has contributed greatly to the advancement of medical science. In the world of professional sports, this is also true. In football, we have specialists in defensive play. We have specialists in kicking. In golf and tennis, all of these great professional athletes, no matter how great they become, even in the world of professional boxing, Muhammad Ali always had a coach, as do all professional sportsmen. They have coaches all the way down the line because no man ever knows all there is to know. Until now, this innovation has never been conceived in the world of professional wrestling. But now it has. Mr. Wrestling, too, has for some time had his eye on Magnum TA. As you know, Mr. Wrestling, too, has a great deal of experience in professional wrestling, and he has decided that it might be good for him to act as a coach to Magnum TA, not as a manager, but a coach.
Well, you've got it right, Reeser. I have spent almost my entire life in wrestling, in athletics all the way around, and I've been watching Magnum T.A. for some time. I've checked on his background. He was an all-state champion in wrestling. He was track and field. He was a track star, shot put. He's gone through a lot. And to do this, you've got to have a lot of heart, determination, drive, whatever you want to call it. It takes a lot for a young man to push himself to those outer limits. Well, I've taken it upon myself. He and I have sat down, we've talked, discussed this, came to a financial agreement, which we won't get into, and I'm going to pass on the knowledge that I have gained over the years to a young man that I feel is going to reach the height of professional wrestling. That doesn't mean that I'm going to quit wrestling. That doesn't mean it's going to interfere with my personal wrestling field, but what it does mean is that I intend to make this man perhaps the finest, the greatest wrestler, I hope, in the wrestling career of that the wrestlers I've ever seen.
Well, that indeed is a great idea, and Magnum T.A. certainly has the stuff to do it with.
You know, Reeser, I got to thinking, when I made my greatest gains, when I made my greatest athletic progress, was at the hands of some of the greatest coaches in the country. This is when I was in the amateur field. And as I've made this climb to the professional level, I left the coaches behind. I've had no one to get the advice from. Now I have a man with 25 years of experience who I respect greatly, and I hope can help me to reach the heights that I wish to attain.
I know there's one question that the fans would like to know. Do you intend to teach this man your famous knee lift?
You have to learn to walk before you jump.
That's an exciting concept. I'm going to look forward to seeing how it develops. Mr. Wrestling 2, with his knowledge and his tremendous ability, Magnum T.A., a youngster who's really impressed everybody. Let's go to Reeser Bowden in the ring to welcome back Mr. Wrestling 2.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 234 pounds from Birmingham, Alabama, Paul Garner. And in the blue corner at 236 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Mr. Wrestling 2.
Paul Garner versus the living legend, a man who just keeps rolling along and victory after victory, Mr. Wrestling number 2. There you see him rolling up his robe. Johnny Martinez signaled for the bell.
Wrestling 2, and Reaser Bowden's last question. Are you going to teach Magnum T.A. the knee lift? But the old fox, Wrestling 2, hadn't said a word about that. Hadn't clarified it. This is a man when everywhere he goes, the crowd goes, two, 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 two. A man with a knee lift, and I've got a scar inside my mouth. Once when I was wrestling, defending the Georgia Heavyweight Championship, he put my teeth through my lip. I can tell you how tough that man is. He loves to compete. And I tell you, I think Magnum T.A. is a lot smarter than people give him credit, because here's a youngster that went out and said his best time that he showed the most growth and the most gains in the sport of amateur wrestling was when he was under great coaching. Taught that technique, those other ways of training that pushed just a little bit further than the other guy. And now he's gone out and made an agreement with Wrestling 2 to be his coach, not his financial manager, his coach. Of course, Wrestling 2 says, I'm not going to let it interfere with my career, but I'm going to take this youngster. He thinks Magnum T.A. is probably the most outstanding young wrestler on the horizon today. But he's got it all, speed, size, and strength. I know a lot of people are starting to really warm to Magnum T.A. as they get to see this youngster who's fought them all. He's already been one half the Mid-South Tag Championship. He's already been, for just a week, a North American champion, which that match and all that effort was invalidated, and the Russian was in it. Fountain Hill Public School, their yearbook editor, Lindy Ebaugh, has written Mid-South and Jack Curtis and saying that they're asking Magnum T.A. for his cooperation, help to select their Wildcat Queen and three finalists for their yearbook out of 11 senior girls. I think it's a great honor. Magnum's excited about it. You know, when the fans out there in television land start wanting to see and to enjoy getting to meet some personable young man like this, it's really a boost to his career, because these guys really like the fact that the people are pulling for him. All right. Paul Garner is really strapping on Wrestling 2 with those big forearm smashes. I'm telling you, there's what I mean. That's the experience factor, you see. He didn't fluster Wrestling 2. Look at the difference. The other man threw 5 or 6 forearm smashes, 2 threw 1, but it had all that explosive power and that drive in it. And Paul Garner paid the price, and the old cat got out of his way, and then he comes in with that coup de grace, that powerful, vicious knee lift. And there's Johnny Martinez. 1, 2, 3, and 2 is back.
And we told you Mr. Wrestling 2 continues to rack up victories. He added one more over Paul Garner. We have more action when we return.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, at 265 pounds, from Paradise Valley, Arizona, Jeff Sword. And in the blue corner, at 205 pounds, from Birmingham, Alabama, Mike Jackson.
From Birmingham, Alabama, in the red, white, and blue, Mike Jackson against the larger Jeff Sword from Paradise Valley, Arizona. Bill, this should be a live one.
Yeah, Jeff Sword's about as wide as he is tall, and Mike Jackson, the quick one that the crowd really likes. Mike always gives it his all. So, boy, we have Robert Lee Inman, Kerry Shelton, Mac Rogers, and Douglas D. Anderegg, some of the cripple children that are here watching Mid-South at the Irish Mill Boys Club as we tape the Mid-South television program, and we're always glad to have those handicapped children. Love to see the light in their eyes when they enjoying something that they love, you know, and they're getting to vicariously be up there in that ring and share that athletic ability. And praise the Lord, I tell you, you count your blessings. Good move, Mike Jackson. Drop toe hold, and But Jeff Sword moving pretty quick around there. Tony Torres up against John King next. We got Mr. Wrestling 2 and Magnum TA will be in a tag bout next week here on television. They said they would appear in a few tag matches. Wrestling 2 felt that that's very important for him to really get the feel and test deeply Magnum TA and be right there on the scene when they're together as being a few key tag matches. And, at the same time, he said there could be some opportunities for them to go against the Mid-South Tag Team Champions, and they'd certainly like to test them, and I know Magnum feels that way also. We'll have a special montage next week of Hacksaw Dugan in his own inimitable style. Nobody else like him. Leaping Lanny Poffa will be here next week. Steve Dr. Death Williams will be here, and there will be a handicap tag team bout, two men against the powerful Russian bear Nikolai Volkov, who we saw today, a man that beat Crusher Darso and beat him very convincingly. And Crusher Darso is a powerful youngster with a tremendous amount of heart. But it's, you know, sometimes like our American amateur heavyweights, when they go against these Russians with so tremendously, so much strength, so much power, so much maturity, and so much technique, sometimes they can take great athletes we have and make it look like they're teaching a lesson out there. And of course, right now, Mike Jackson is really carrying it to Jeff Sword, who's a lot bigger than him. Mike, good move there. I think Jeff was spotting that next move going. And like I say, when you're doing these high-risk moves, you can't go to the well too often. Reflecting back on Butch Reed, denying and calling Junkyard Dog, saying he was slandering him. I'll tell you, if Dog has heard about it or seen Reed walking through town with that poor little puppy on a chain painted yellow, it's enough to make anybody's hair curl. And Jim Ross said that little puppy felt wet after that interview, and that maybe that he just had a bath. Butch Reed certainly has lost his gears and thinking, I can. 1, 2, 3. Jeff Sword.
Jeff Sword, the winner over Mike Jackson. We have time remaining. That means we'll have more action coming up when we return after this word from Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
This event is for one fall or remaining television time. In the red corner at 226 pounds from St. Petersburg, Florida, John King. And in the blue corner at 218 pounds from Houston, Texas, Tony Torres.
One fall or TV time remaining, John King versus Houston's Tony Torres. Pee Wee Anderson, referee, and he calls for the bell. Action underway, Bill.
Well, it's my first time seeing John King, Boyd Pierce, but I've seen Tony Torres, and I've really been impressed with him. He's not a big man, but he's one of those kids that trains hard. He puts it all in his whole heart into it, and he's been against some monsters here on Mid-South. He's been against some tough guys. He's taken his lumps. And Grizzly Smith, I think, has really got him matched evenly here, as far as we know from all the pre-publicity on John King. They're about the same size and about the same experience level. And this is the kind of match I really enjoy every now and then, is let these youngsters have a little more even chance. And oftentimes, they got some awesome guys to go against. And, of course, when you're trying to get started in pro wrestling, that's the only way. You got to take what you can get. About 2 minutes of air time left, Boyd.
Two minutes time remaining. Action continues fast and furious. We'll stay right with it all the way. Remember, next week, Mastin 2 teams up with Magnum TA in a tag match, and I won't be able to be here next week. Cold weather's coming in, so I'll make my annual trek to Nebraska for pheasant hunting, along with some of the popular stars of years ago, former referee and wrestler Danny Fletches, Joe Dusick, the promoter in Omaha, Nebraska, Richie Ashburn, former great outfielder for the Philadelphia Phillies, and a farm boy, Bill, from Van Meter, Iowa, a few years ago, Rapid Bobby Feller, a group that this will be our 15th straight year. We'll be there, but you'll be in capable hands because Jim Ross will be your host next week on Mid-South, and our guest commentator for the color will be Buddy Nichols from Alexandria, Louisiana.
Oh, that's great, Boyd. I know those pheasants will all be safe, but the stories that will be swapped up there will probably they'll probably chill a few folks.
Exactly.
These two youngsters both trying for a win here on national TV. Tony Torres. Like I say, this Tony, I've watched him, and I've watched him take his lumps and be up against some awesome people. He's never complained. He's gone out and given it 100%, and he started upsetting some guys. Guys started thinking they had the buffalo in on him, and they sure didn't. Now, Tony, just every time, you're going to have to prove that you can whip him. And he may not be too fancy, but he'll be in shape. Got a lot of heart. John King looks like a powerful young man. The inside cradle, both men could have a fall right here. He got out, Boyd. We're fast running out of time.
Running out of time for our fine producer, Director Oral Link, our engineer John Stokely, and the great group of cameramen, Paul White and Ricky Cottingham. Our time is just about gone. We'll stay with it to the end. Thank you so much for viewing us every week on Mid-South Wrestling. I'm Boyd Pierce, along with our guest commentator, Cowboy Bill Watt, saying thank you so much until next week.